The Hive. Turtle's favorite candy was cherry cordials, which might not seem relevant, but is. When Jonas had first met Turtle, he was small enough to fit into his hand, and smart enough to make a nuisance of himself stealing honeycomb from his beehives. He was now large enough for Jonas to ride comfortably on his back, and smart enough to continue to be a nuisance. Not that the beekeeper would have him any other way. Nobody knew where the hive came from. Some said stars, and others blamed one of the dark gods. There was a tale of a magic experiment gone wrong. Jonas always said later that was the take that made the most sense. Hive bees were large, not monstrously large, of course, certainly not the size of a dragon or even anywhere near. They were the size of one's fist, which was formidable enough for a bee, and fast, which was why they were so hard for the knights to fight. All that heavy armor and weaponry didn't make one very fast, though it did provide a great deal more protection against the hive's bee stingers than Jonas' traveling tunic. The hive had taken over the town of Greencliff, which was one of the major trading posts of the kingdom. Some of the townsfolk had lost their lives, and the rest had been forced to flee. The king had sent in his army, which had been soundly defeated, when Jonas and Turtle arrived. In truth, they'd only come to Greencliff to sell their honey, as they did every year. But Jonas couldn't refuse the king's request for help, and Turtle would never turn down a reward that involved a box of cherry cordials. The hive bees, as Jonas discovered on steps of the village, were just regular bees. They'd set up their hive in town hall and weren't a threat when left alone. They would have returned without incident if not for Turtle's sweet tooth. Once the hive was moved, Jonas became its keeper. Honey became the kingdom's main export, and Turtle was never without a box of cherry cordials.